Bonjour tout le monde. Merci d'être ici. Je suis accompagné aujourd'hui de la vice-première ministre Freeland et des ministres Joly et Anand. On est ici pour parler des actions inacceptables de la Russie en Ukraine. Le Canada condamne la reconnaissance par le président Poutine de Donetsk et Luhansk comme territoire indépendant. Canada strongly condemns President Putin's recognition of Donetsk and Luhansk as so-called independent states. This recognition is a violation of Russia's obligations under international law and the Charter of the United Nations. Canada also denounces Russian military actions, including orders to move into Ukraine, which is a clear incursion of Ukraine's sovereignty and territorial integrity. Make no mistake, this is a further invasion of a sovereign state, and it is completely unacceptable. President Putin's speech yesterday was inaccurate and contained dangerous misinformation. Russia's brazen provocations are a threat to security and peace in the world. I have been in constant contact with President Zelensky and our partners and allies since this crisis began. Last Friday, I had a call with President Biden, Prime Minister Johnson, President Macron, Chancellor Scholz, and other European leaders about the situation. And yesterday, I spoke again with President von der Leyen of the European Commission. We are united and steadfast in our support of Ukraine and have made clear that Russian aggression will result in severe consequences. So today, in coordination with allies and like-minded partners, Canada is announcing a first round of economic sanctions. We will ban Canadians from all financial dealings with the so-called independent states of Luhansk and Donetsk. We will sanction members of the Russian Parliament who voted for the illegal decision to recognize these so-called republics. We will ban Canadians from engaging in purchases of Russian sovereign debt. And we will apply additional sanctions on two state-backed Russian banks and prevent any financial dealings with them. These sanctions are a major step and target those responsible for violating the sovereignty and territorial integrity of Ukraine. And they will remain in place until the territorial integrity of Ukraine is restored. Aujourd'hui, en coordination avec nos alliés et partenaires, le Canada annonce l'imposition d'une première série de sanctions économiques. On va interdire aux Canadiens de faire toute transaction financière avec les territoires indépendants, soi-disant de Luhansk et de Donetsk. On va imposer des sanctions aux membres du Parlement russe qui ont voté pour la décision illégale de reconnaître ces territoires. On va interdire aux Canadiens de participer à des achats de la dette souveraine russe. Et on va imposer des sanctions supplémentaires contre les banques russes soutenues par l'État et interdire toute transaction financière avec elles. Ces sanctions marquent une étape importante et ciblent les responsables des violations de la souveraineté et de l'intégrité territoriale de l'Ukraine. Elles vont rester en place jusqu'à ce que l'intégrité territoriale de l'Ukraine soit rétablie. It is not too late for Russia to seek a diplomatic resolution and re-establish a pathway to peace. But it is also clear that Russian actions violate international law and threaten international peace and security. So today, I am also authorizing a deployment of up to 460 members of the Canadian Armed Forces to Operation Reassurance. This involves more troops to Latvia, as well as the deployment of an additional frigate and maritime patrol aircraft. We're doing this to reinforce our commitment to NATO and promote peace and security in Europe. We're also stepping up our support for NATO. Canada has pledged significant additional medical, aircraft, naval, and land capabilities to the NATO Response Force. This is something that NATO requested from members and will bolster our support of partners and allies. Minister Anand will provide more details in a moment. À tous les membres des Forces armées canadiennes en Lettonie, merci pour votre travail formidable. Vous continuez d'incarner la force et les valeurs canadiennes dans la région. Je tiens aussi à m'adresser aux Canadiens qui sont actuellement en Ukraine. Votre sûreté et votre sécurité sont une priorité absolue. To Canadians currently in Ukraine, your safety and security are a top priority. Consular services are available in Lviv, and you can reach out to Global Affairs Emergency Watch and Response Center to get support. Their email is sos@international.gc.ca, and phone or messaging numbers are available online. And to the Ukrainian-Canadian community here at home, I know the situation is deeply concerning. Your community has made significant contributions to building Canada, and we will stand with you every step of the way. Earlier today, I spoke with the President of the Canadian-Ukrainian Congress and reaffirmed Canada's resolute and ongoing support of Ukraine. Au cours des dernières années et des dernières semaines, le Canada a fourni des ressources importantes pour aider l'Ukraine à se défendre. Depuis 2015, dans le cadre de l'opération Unifiée, les membres des Forces armées canadiennes ont formé plus de 30 000 membres des forces de sécurité de l'Ukraine. Le mois dernier, on a prolongé et élargi cette mission de formation. On a aussi accordé des prêts au gouvernement de l'Ukraine pouvant aller à jusqu'à 620 millions de dollars et on a fourni de l'équipement ainsi que de l'armement et des munitions qui sont présentement dans les mains de l'armée ukrainienne. Le Canada va continuer d'être là pour soutenir l'Ukraine et sa population. Russia's flagrant disregard for the independence of a sovereign nation is a serious threat to security and stability in the region and around the world. Canada and our allies will defend democracy. We are taking these actions today to stand against authoritarianism. The people of Ukraine, like all people, must be free to determine their own future. We will continue working with our international partners to safeguard Ukraine's territorial integrity and prevent further Russian aggression.